This is the story of the happiest 3 months of my life.
Goodbye, shitty vodka. Goodbye, half-eaten hot Cheetos. Goodbye, unrefrigerated ranch. Goodbye, pan we never clean. Goodbye, clothes I never washed because the...
Alright, hold on. Let's start at the beginning.
Sun is down, freezing cold. That's how we already know. When it's here, my dog will probably do it for Louis Bell. That's just all he know, he don't know nothing else. I tried to show him. Yeah. I tried to show him.
I needed some change. I said I needed some change. Can someone please turn this? All right, thank you. I needed some change.
Bro!
Ow!
All right, you see that piece of shit on the ground? Yeah, that piece of shit's me. Drunk off my ass after a typical night out of college, having absolutely no idea what I'm gonna do with my life. Don't get me wrong. College is great. College is necessary, and I'm gonna end up finishing my degree. I've been at school for 2 years now, and I just needed a break. I needed some adventure. I was tired of just waking up every morning and doing the same shit every single day. College is fine. It gets the job done. It gets people to a better life. I just needed a break. I needed some adventure. I attend the University of Kansas, and I was born in Illinois, so the Midwest is absolutely the only thing I've known my entire life. Until I went out to Montana this summer, the farthest west I'd been in my entire life was like somewhere in Colorado when I was like 3 or 4 years old. So really, I had not been like further west than Kansas really, because like I don't really remember that trip to Colorado. And like I said before, college is great, college gets the job done. I had just fallen into a rut where I was just partying too much. I wasn't really enjoying the things like the outdoors and adventures like I usually like to do. I needed something more, I needed some adventure, and this past summer was that more for me. Wow, look at that sun flare. Sunlight coming through the water, hand in the air. Yeah, it's too cheesy for me too. Hold up, I got it. In just under 2 weeks in Montana, I've already gone on more hikes, more adventures, and experienced more and seen more than I had my entire life. So two main places to work in Big Sky, Montana over the summer would be either A, down in the golf course in the valley, that's where I worked, or B, up top of the base camp, which that had like zip line tours, tours of Lone Peak, and like mountain biking and stuff like that. So the base camp didn't open until June 1st, but the golf course was open early May, but I didn't get out of school until like May 12th, somewhere around there. But I got to Big Sky around May 20th, so that's when I started working. So until all the base camp workers got there, I knew absolutely nobody except for a few people I worked with. I didn't have a roommate or anything. But on June 1st, my adventure turned into...
Just got stuck.
knocked off by a grizzly. It was pretty tight.
Did you go piss?
Oh, what?
You piss?
Yeah.
What the fuck is that? A giant rock penis?
Wait, okay, let's get a ruling on this.
I might honestly go bust a nut on there.
Our adventure.
Made this here with all the ice on in the booth. At the gate outside when
they pull up. Dear alcohol loud as shit.
That fascinating human being right there is Dustin. He was my roommate. The most beautiful quality of Dustin would be his middle school maturity level to the point where he will belly laugh at fart noises. Dustin then introduced me to 0069 frat star, Anderson, aka Andy.
Oh, show your tits!
And finally, Dirty Dave, the most confident southern man you will ever meet. And an honorable mention, Dustin's star-crossed lover, Anna. We were all working 4 days on, 3 days off, with 10-hour days. So our 3 days off, we honestly just booled around in the entire western United States. It was incredible. It's just a touristy spot, because we left at 6 p.m. last night, and it's now 7 a.m. It's a little over 12 hours ago. We was like, hey, you guys want to go camping in Yellowstone? We didn't prepare for this for lunch. This is after day one of camping in Yellowstone. Here's what it kind of looks like. That's Dustin and Anderson's tent. And if you look just past it, you can see the Eno that I tried to sleep in. It lasted till about 7 a.m. because it got way too cold and I almost lost a toe. It was like RVs everywhere. I saw a guy running over there, like, what are you doing? Go to bed. Why are you running? It's like, this isn't your normal neighborhood routine. Go back in your tent, stop running, you're stupid.
All right, we're like 30 minutes. There's some dunes out there somewhere. Oh. 0.5 miles.
Can I park right here?
Probably not. There's a sign that says no parking.
To the teats.
To the teats.
Here come the teats.
The glacier's just on yonder.
That's gonna be incredibly terrifyingly cold.
Here we've got the wild Anderson and Dustin.
Let's do this, guys. Pull up in the drop top.
Right there is a mountain.
This is Hidden Falls, very hidden. Oh, Anderson found it.
Here it is.
There it is. We found it.
Dude, there's a fucking Ferrari. We just passed a Ferrari in fucking Idaho.
Andy!
Make sure you get my dick bowl.
This is Anderson. My nipples to show people how big they are.
Vagina.
Oh, I look like a fucking douche.
Where are we at today, Anderson?
Buttfuck nowhere,
can't. The wild Anderson relieving himself in the woods.
God, get me in my worst moment.
I think I'm on record. Let's hope so.
A big lunge step? Like, you're gonna just be able to, like, hug the rock at the top, I promise.
Oh, you're trying to get the fucking hits to pick you.
We're gonna just mute that part out.
To everyone that had an impact on my life this summer, thank you. It was absolutely incredible. I'll never forget you. Love you, Big Sky.